growing up. I didn't really like the buzzer. I knew what to do, what people do, but I didn't really like it. I was always standing up for goal, I'd always score them and then just get back up and do the actual wasting the time on scoring on the buzzer. And I kept, when I changed weight categories, I raised 552s, it was okay. And then I changed weight categories and I moved it to 48s and I kept getting loads of drops in Niagara players. So that's when I started developing the Rolls Triangle and what to do is map. So my move is the Rolls Triangle, it's always from someone dropping. It always used to be, I wanted to throw my big hands over, I just threw them over and come onto them. They were dropping on me. And if I didn't break enough, they would just flip over. So I did learn something. But when you do that, how can I slow over there without myself getting penalised? What I always do, it's always been, usually the side you've got lifting on, at the drop, because I'm throwing that side, quite a lot of that side I'm going to drop on, because that's the side I'm leaning mostly on, but it's the side I can brace the best as well. Usually for me, I'm trying to get the corner grip or a bottom lapel, but I'm still holding them because I'm not in the big throw. So as they drop, I brace my arm, but I pull it straight away under, and then I step over. But once I step over, I really have to squeeze my hips before I roll. So I get the roll in, so I get the drop, always spin before I roll, quickly grab, and then I roll. Once I roll, that's when I can take my time a little bit. I try and pull the leg up to the head as far as I can, and my wrist. So once I'm pulling with my wrist, I used to always just keep my wrist there and just try and bend my partner, and realise, wondered why they were at that point they were just about to tap and they wouldn't tap. But what I realised is, if I keep my wrist really straight, that's actually where all the actual pain on the person comes from. It doesn't matter how hard I pull with my arms and squeeze the person, they're not going to tap, the strangle's not going to go on. But if I just turn my wrist, just slightly, the strangle comes on a lot faster. I used to do a nice job. So it's just a turn. What we're just going to practice is that bit. But you need to get that split second. You can't jump on the leg or you'll get penalised because if you touch the legs out, you get hands up on your shield first and then your hands up on that. So once you drop, I put my hand on the back just to be the brace, so it looks like showing that I'm bracing, and I pull up. As I step with that leg, I squeeze with my hips. I give it a quick pull just before I roll, just to make sure it's tight, and then I jump through the gap. And then it's from here, that's when you get in the best whatever position. Leg on the shoulder to keep it pinned, or just through. But I want to keep my wrist nice and straight, that's what pulls on the strangle, and just lean back. I'm just going to get you to go away and practice the rolling bit first, and then I'll show you what I had to develop from when I couldn't get through the rolling. So we'll practice this one first. The main point is that wrist, once I roll them, it's keeping the wrist straight. You can go bend it with your neck, but just keep it straight, because that's the way things are tied in. So off you go.